Evening folks, this is Best in Slot with the final exhibit build for Mai Pen Rai, our Asian tropical zoo. Now of course we're going to move on to many more zoos after that. Franchise mode is going to go on for a very long time, but we're putting Asian tropical aside just for now after today. Now before we do that however, we're going to hop over into our, this is my breeding zoo, in case you missed the end of the last video. I did a little tour of that, so go check it out. I've been breeding gorillas because I want to complete the community challenge, which is to release a certain number of gorillas into the wild. So I think I've just about managed to hit the very top tier. It took me 51 gorillas to hit the very top tier. Now that number will go up the further you get into the challenge, just because the number is based on kind of like your ranking within the community. I think you have to be in like the top 1% to hit the top rank, something like that. So the top 1% will have more gorillas later on, so it gets harder and harder to break in. So I do recommend you do these challenges earlier rather than later. But anyways, I haven't claimed a single reward, so just like last time, I'm going to claim them all, and we'll see what we get. Quite exciting. Oh. 9, 10, 11, 12. Let's see what we've got here. Should be, right, 500cc. We've got a lovely new outfit. An amazing gorilla hat. The overall outfit's a bit odd. We've got a zebra, we've got an elephant, and we've got a rhino. We've got some decent quality animals. If they are decent, we'll keep hold of those and we'll bring those into our future zoos as well. Anyways, we're gonna hop over to Mai Pen right now and get our franchise mode on the go. One further addendum to that, as I have donned what is quite frankly the most beautiful costume I've ever seen. It's like this tormented, horrifying gorilla is chomping down on my skull. Honestly, it's the dream. This is by far the best costume in the entire game. I think we can all agree with that. We've also got the armadillo hat there, we've got the tiger hat from the last challenge. I think we can safely say the gorilla is leaps and bounds above it. I suspect if you do miss out on these will come back. They're not going to keep making new outfits for every single challenge every week. That would be madness. So don't fret too much if you miss out this time. I'm sure they'll be back in the future. Right, now to Mai Pen Rai. Right then folks, welcome back to a dark and stormy Mai Pen Rai. Yes, the nighttime is officially working. I don't know if it's been patched or if I magically did something. I didn't change opening times or anything like that, but apparently daytime, nighttime is now working. So it means I need lights, annoyingly. Thankfully, I'd already kind of lit this area up already. It's looking very pretty. As you can see, there is our lovely thingamajiggy. Now, as already, look at the boats. That's actually gorgeous. As already mentioned, we are going to do the Saltwater Crocodile exhibit today. I want to address this because I've had like 5,000 comments about it. People saying, don't you mean the gharial? No, I don't mean the gharial. And I'll tell you for why. Asia has Saltwater Crocodile and gharial. Oceania also has Saltwater Crocodile. We will be bringing the Saltwater Crocodile back for a second exhibit in Oceania. But I wanted Asia to have both crocodiles as well, so we're using both. Saltwater crocodile is in both. I already had comments saying that it's only in Oceania, and that's wrong. If we go down, you get saltwater crocodiles in like the coasts of India. So if we find our salty, there he is. Natural habitat, Asia, Oceania. So that's why the saltwater crocodile is being in Asia. Second reason we're doing saltwater crocodile, as you can see, it's aquatic and tropical. Those are the only two biomes for the saltwater crocodile. If we go up here, however, and we find the gharial, there it is, we can see it's temperate and tropical, okay? So I'm doing a temperate Asian zoo. I've already planned it out. There's going to be 7 animals in it. That's going to be a zoo we do down the line. And I figured each zoo should have 1 crocodile each, right? That's a more fair way to spread them out. And since the gharial is temperate and tropical, and the saltwater is only tropical, and this is a tropical zoo, the saltwater had to go into this zoo. Okay? Can I have, please have no more comments about it. I trust me, I know what I'm doing. I planned it all out meticulously. I really did. Every single zoo in the game, every single animal is accounted for. Right, so the reason we're here and unpaused is the exhibit is at this point done. I'm gonna have a nice little time lapse now. Didn't take that long this one, so enjoy the time lapse of the crocodile exhibit and then we'll hop back and finish off the episode. And this will in fact be the final exhibit episode of Mai Pen Rai. So next episode we'll do a full zoo tour and then we're gonna move on to something else. Not sure what yet, but we'll talk about that later. Enjoy. Here we go then folks, saltwater crocodile exhibit. And this one, it took a little bit of time to come up with. It really did. I was dabbling for a long time trying to come up with a unique idea, some cool way of viewing the saltwater crocodile. I actually sat here with a pen and paper again and sketched it out. The sketch is utter nonsense. It looks just nothing like anything, but it made sense to me and I managed to kind of put something together. I had a vision in my head from the very start of really wanting to implement a big cliff, right? Because I love my cliffs and it very much suits the aesthetic we have across the whole park. You know, this whole area kind of has a big cliff, earthquakey aesthetic. As much as earthquake can be an aesthetic, that is our aesthetic, right? It just is. And I had this idea in my head of these flat-topped mountains that kind of push out from the world and are covered in trees and life and stuff like that. It turns out it's from Up, you know, Up, the Pixar film. There's a scene where they're in, well, most of the film towards the end, they're in South America. And there's this bit, it comes out like that above this massive gorge. And it's not above water, it's above like a forest, but there's this cliff that comes out and it's flat topped, like rugged on the side and covered in forest. So I really like the idea of having that for the future so we can put an exhibit there down the line and then have that overlooking the top of the Saltwater Crocodile exhibit. I also wanted to extend the gorge we had earlier. This is deep, this is deeper than everything else. I wanted to just mix it up a little bit and I wanted to implement a boat tour. So that's all stuff we're gonna do. So the idea is to hollow out the side of this mountain a little bit. This is me trying to put lights in and then remembering that lights do not work in the middle of the day, so I don't know why, but it's like super dark. I don't know why the lights don't work, but lights don't work in the middle of the day. The day-night cycle, as you saw a little earlier, does actually come back, but it didn't come back until quite a bit later on into this. So I tried making like sky lights and stuff like that, but at the end of the day it didn't really work and I just kind of went for it. So I've dug a hole into the side of the mountain. The idea is this is going to be raised up above the rest of the water. This is where the crocodiles are going to come to eat and mate and, you know, chill under their barriers, and also there'll be a human point, there'll be a human person bit where they can A, observe the crocodiles and also get on the boat. Now, the landscape itself has a pretty good in-universe reasoning. You know, this is the chasm, you know, this is, we've established this across the entire park. It is the aesthetic language of the park, is water, chasms, and forest. Basically, those are the big three. In terms of why the locals would put a boat ride down here, I'm less sure. Again, we can justify it pretty simply. It's just saying they need to make a bit of money for the conservation efforts. Or maybe, I mean, it makes sense, boat tour in this kind of area, but maybe it was, I don't know. Let's pretend it's a rescue operation, right? So this big chasm's opened up, it's full of crocodiles, and maybe there used to be people who lived in the area, and people have gone missing, and now this boat is circling around looking for survivors in the area or something like that, and docking at the nearby thing. Or, alternatively, they're just trying to make a bit of money for the conservation efforts. Probably makes more sense. So just setting up the land here, I was really nervous about this, about getting this to work. It took quite a lot of, it doesn't look that complex, but to make this work in my head took quite a lot of thinking, just to get it all to come together properly so that the humans could come round and land and then get on the boat and then go around and tour properly, you know? So there's a lot of testing out the waters and raising up these things just to get it all perfect. I wanted it to be mainly water, but little pockets of land, just to create some interest more than anything else. And same with this, you don't really see under the water, but you get little glimpses of it in the bright light, and you just see how ragged the bottom is. It just looks a little bit more natural, basically. That's right, I said the word. It took me, what, 3 minutes 50 though? Not bad. Not bad at all. So again, same idea. Nice calm water, there's nothing particularly influencing it other than the inevitable waterfall that we had later. And I wanted to get the path in nice and early because this was, again, something I was a little bit worried about. So, long, long path right down here. This is the only way in and out so far. I like the idea of doing, because I want to do an exhibit on top of here, like down the line when like a DLC comes out. I like the idea of doing like a staircase within the mountain that takes you up to the top of the mountain and then you could access that exhibit from there. It sounds pretty complex, but it's definitely an idea for the future. Now, for the boat. I am going to screw up here, and I do apologise because it's going to take a couple of minutes. I'm doing my boat tour. This is the first time I've done the boat tour. I had a little practice round earlier, but the first time I've tried to make a complete boat tour on this exhibit ever. So, it was a little finicky. I hate the track placement in this game. I think it's horrendously designed. I had no idea what it was designed like that, but yeah, as it turns out, it was on the wrong side. So, had to delete it and redo the tour again and face the other way. Unfortunately, I would have liked the face the other way, like back that way, the other, you know what I mean? But, you know, it is what it is. I hate this. Why is it not like the monorail in Jurassic World Evolution? That'd be so much easier. I realize it's more complex and that's probably why, but still, it's such a pain in the ass. But there we go, boating around. I will say the autocomplete works pretty well. This took some work. Again, I did not really know how the boat tour worked, but you have to put your entrance down, your exit down, and then I'm trying to get the path onto the ground in the right texture, and we're going to connect them up. So you'll come down here, you can get onto the boat. We've got a queue. You do need a queue for the entrance. There she is, or he, I actually can't remember. And if you want, you can also check out the crocodiles before you hop on to the boat tour. I think it's a really cool little idea. Yeah, it came together really, really well. This one I was pretty confident. Like, by the time I got to this point, I was feeling pretty good about it. There is another minor hurdle to cross, and we'll get to that in a moment. Just trying out the power. This doesn't work, unfortunately. I do end up putting a transformer at the back. Oddly enough, that solar panel does work. It doesn't look like it should, but it does actually work in that location right there. But unfortunately, it's not connected to the path. And now we get to the barrier. This was the other major hurdle. This is really the only other thing that went badly, to an extent. Everything else is smooth sailing. This was a little bit horrendous. I don't know if there's a better way to do this than I did, but you'll see. So we're doing null barrier all the way around. Of course, the cliff side is a fairly natural boundary anyway. I'm going to come all the way around here. I think I'm going to end up backing up just a little bit about now. Yep, gone too far. Back we go. And we're trying to cross over there. Now, this is the problem. Because there's no... Like, with the tour vehicle, the car, there's like a tour gate. That doesn't, as far as I know, exist for the boat. Maybe it does. Maybe other people are doing this in different... I don't know how other people are doing this. You'll see here, this is the problem. The barrier does not come up hard enough, far enough, hard enough, in order to block completely. And when I put the crocodiles in, and then we are going to put them in during this time lapse, just because I had to get this sorted, you'll see that they can escape all along there. Now, I think usually people keep the boat self-contained within the exhibit, if that makes sense, but I still don't understand how you surround that in a barrier. I actually full-on don't understand the boat tour at all, but I do make this work. And I think it actually looks pretty cool at the end of the day. So, just attaching all this stuff, we're going to do a little staff area in a sec. Are we doing that now? Yep. Just hiding a couple of staff facilities down here at the back. Again, maybe not the most efficient way of doing it necessarily, but we don't care about money. Like, we're never making money, so I figure at this point we lean into it, really, you know? Next zoo is going to be much more controlled. We're going, like I said, probably to North America, and we'll chill a little bit, you know? It'll be North America or Africa, but we already did Africa fairly recently, so... And we'll chill a little bit. It's going to be chill. It's going to be less... Hopefully I can actually hang around in my own zoo to make money. That's the goal, basically. So, Crocky is in. Throat is weird. And that's the problem. Lots and lots of issues there. The crocodile is just able to basically swim away, which is a slight problem when you've got a man-eating reptile. So, the solution, as always, in all walks of life, ladies and gentlemen, the solution is rocks. And it is possible to block the whole area off with rocks and let the boat still get through and not cause a problem. And it looks really good. I think it looks great. It blocks it off and lets you put the boat outside of the tour. And the whole thing looks really cool and natural. And there you go. The crocodile is officially trapped at that point in time. It's oddly effective. I was really worried about it for a moment. I was racking my brain trying to think, how would you ever usually do this? But yeah, we got there eventually. Little problem with the boat tour here, just, excuse me, refused to work. I think the wind turbine, like the solar panel, needs to be in certain places. There's no wind at the back of the cave, basically, so it doesn't work. So decided to just bring in an old transformer instead. Robots in this, nope. What was I doing here? Yeah, so I actually don't have much CC at the moment because I'm working on something for the next episode. I spent like 50,000 CC today, something stupid, but I needed some cash, and for some reason the cash market in franchise mode has disappeared. Frontier are full on not selling animals for cash anymore. Every now and again a few will pop up, like cheap ones. It used to be mandrills and hippos, and they're just never there anymore. Maybe very rarely, but I used to be reliably every 30 seconds you could buy them. I think they've taken them out, I don't know why, but they're gone for some reason. And it's a big shame, it's really causing me some problems. So my solution now has to be to buy some cheap CC animals and sell those instead. Thankfully, we're done with this zoo for now, so I don't need to deal with this anymore. Because it's been a massive pain in the ass, but there you go. Crocodile was very, very nearly happy. I love that, by the way. You open up the boat and these things, get, like sparklers, go freaking crazy at the start. It's like New Year's Eve all over again. Excuse me, sorry about that. Bloody Nora. A little bit of rock. Don't want the palm trees. Doesn't really suit the feeling we're going for. We get rid of those. Just a little bit of plant life necessary, I think. But again, I do keep it, by my standards, I will say, by my standards, relatively chill. there's a few plants there, just make the whole thing feel a little bit more au naturel, which is how I'm going to say it now, because I say natural all the time, now I can be fancy about it. Yeah, I think that's about where I stop. A little bit of grass, and then it's too much grass, and we have to add some rock. Blah, 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 blah. This is only on times 5 speed, by the way. This is probably the slowest time-lapse we've done. The entire build only took an hour and a half, an hour and 45 minutes. I think it's actually the quickest build I've done in the entire park. It isn't quite done. Some stuff needs to be done around the outside, but generally speaking, it's pretty finished. One of the reasons it was quick, I'm sure, is because it's 99% water, so... I did really want to do underwater viewing, but I will say I don't feel like it really fit the exhibit or indeed the zoo theme in general. You know, I just don't think it was appropriate. We'll do that for other zoos and other animals, you know, but not in any rush here. What I really wanted to get the feeling across here with this chasm, there's always a feeling, it's just this world under the water that you're not really privy to. You're going past on the boat and you're seeing like the little bits of a couple of trees have sprouted all the way up, but generally speaking you're going to see rocks and leaves and stuff underneath the water. The water isn't that deep, but by adding all this stuff that you can't really make out, it kind of gives the illusion of depth that isn't there. You know, all you see is this stuff popping up and you don't know how far down it goes. You don't know what's under there. You don't know how many crocodiles, what fish, you know, God knows what else is lurking down in the depths of the water. That's kind of why the plants and stuff like that, basically. There's always a thing. Another thing I really want to do, and I know we've done a lot of waterfalls, but I really liked the idea of the boat going right past the waterfall, basically. Like, basically under, not quite underneath, but nearly underneath. So I thought we'd jut out of the mountain just a little bit and have like a little bit of a, like the jutty bit. It makes sense, it would collect the water because it's jutting out from the mountainside. So as the water falls, it's going to collect in that kind of area anyway. I am going to get rid of the sky hole. Is that what you call it? A sky hole? Sun hole. A sunlight. Sun. I'm going to call it a sky hole. So yeah, just making a little bit of water here and that's going to topple over the edge. And it looks really cool. It really does. I actually got the waterfall itself looking a lot better than usual. I think there's a very specific way you should stack the, you know what I mean? And the middle bit, the bottom bit, right? There's a very specific way you should stack those to make it look natural. I've not found a good way to make the end of the waterfall because there has to be a lip of terrain. So you can't have the water just come straight to the edge, which is a shame because that'd be really cool. The only good way to do it, in my opinion, is to use rocks. You could also go crazy with the foam, I guess. But, yeah, whatever. I like rocks. Rocks are cool. Rocks are the best. And here we go. Nighttime for the first time. I don't know why. I really don't. I don't know what's changed, why I've had night. This is literally the first nighttime I've had in this entire park. Now, bearing in mind, I've probably spent about 30 hours in this zoo, at least. At least. It's probably more. I'd say 30 to 40 hours I've been spent in this park already. And now this is our first night time, so I don't know what that's all about. Admittedly, I've been paused for a lot of that time, but I've been unpaused for hours at least as well. So I was impressed that it's night time. It's cool. I wanted to go around and have a little look at everything. And of course, everything needs a little bit of light. So this took a little bit of time trying to figure out how I'm going to light this bottom area up. I put down these lampposts and then tried about 500 other things and then realized that the lampposts were the right choice. So... we'll end up going back to those in a minute. These are cool, but you need too many of them to light it effectively. It kind of looks weird, a little bit cultish in a way, and I'm usually down for a cult, but this wasn't in a culty mood. You know, you have to be in a culty mood. You know what I mean? So, screwing around with all the lights, and then we go back to the lampposts. But trying to keep it a little bit more tame this time. And these are the lampposts we used up in the village itself as well, so it kind of makes a lot of sense. What am I doing? Education boards for our salties. And yeah, just trying to make... I always had this problem where I couldn't make the water go all the way down, if that makes sense. It always kind of like the water came at the top, and then if you added more of these, it kind of looked like there was the white bits and it kind of restarted midway through and it looked stupid. But I do think if you put them in the right spot, you can get rid of that and it ends up looking really... Look at that, the crocodile! You're going to see that properly in a minute. The crocodile... half in the water with the waterfall in the distance and the rain pouring down at night time. It looks awesome. If you can see it, like, you might need to turn your brightness up because my screen is already pretty bright. And I know some people don't like it when I build at night time. I never do it on purpose, especially in this park because this park's never night time. So I did consider that, but I decided against it. A little bit of construction work here, not much. Literally just covering this in wood just so it blends in a little bit better. I think I could do some general decoration work down here. The next video, like I said, no, like I will say in a minute, it's very confusing sometimes this, it's going to be a tour video, so I'm going to get a little bit more done before then, a little bit more decoration and stuff like that, but you've seen basically everything. This is the last bit of the park, folks. I'm kind of going to miss it, but I'm excited to do something else. I'm excited to do a park that's a little bit more zoo-like, you know, that's going to be pretty cool as well. A little bit of light in here, I think. You know what, the more that I look at it, the more that I like that that's the only lit up bit of the shelter, so I might get rid of these little lights, considering it. Although I think they look pretty cool. I'm thinking about it, We'll see. Anyways, rock time! Gotta make the waterfall look a little bit more natural, because the water never quite hits in a way that would make a waterfall, because it has to have that terrain lip at the end. The rocks kind of hide that a little bit, and you can kind of justify it away a little easier, in my opinion. That's my theory, anyway. I love how these plants look at night. Nighttime in the rain is just... oh, it's the guaranteed way to make me happy, especially with a croc like that. Anyways, there we go. That's it, folks. That is the entire exhibit. See? Not that long at all. Gonna be a surprisingly short video. I really like it. I think it really came together at the end. Really, really kind of proud of it, to be honest, despite it being my quickest build. I think that's because it's primarily water and terrain work, but that is our final exhibit. Hope you guys enjoyed the time-lapse. We're now going to come back for 7 or so minutes, have a look at the crocodiles, go on a little boat ride, do a little bit more decoration, talk about the future of the series and stuff like that. So, until then. No, I don't need to say goodbye. I'm about to talk to you. Okay, I'll see you in a second. Alright, time-lapse over. Let's check out our salty exhibit. I have put many, many lights up, as you can see. I just wanted to showcase this whilst we're here at nighttime with the rain, because I think it looks really, really, really cool, basically. And if we go forward past the rocks over here, you can actually see the saltwater crocodile there, chilling next to the waterfall in the rain. That is proper... That's what a saltwater crocodile should look like. That kind of almost horror movie-esque effect there, where it's just sitting and waiting in the water, in the rain, waterfall behind him. He's waiting for someone to drive past. And we do have people driving past. The boat is on its way. Look at it go. Chugga, 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 chugga. We can actually, if I click this correctly, we should be able to have a little ride. There we go. There's the front view. Let's go onto a seat. Oh, we are on a seat. Can I change seats? No, we have to sit here. Okay, there we go. We'll just enjoy this second half. I really like how this looks, especially at nighttime, especially in the rain. It looks really dramatic, really cool. Surprised it didn't take that long. Definitely got the entire feeling I wanted. I'm sure I mentioned this in the video, but this whole bit up there, like, obviously we're done with Asian Tropical for now, but I'm assuming a DLC will come out. That up there is going to be an exhibit right on the edge of the cliff that then overlooks the crocodile exhibit. That's going to be very cool as well. I'd like to see the crocodile whilst we're on the boat tour. I have got a male and female breeding pair, specifically because crocodiles only live in pairs of 2, unfortunately. So what I want is like 25 babies swimming around the exhibit. That would help a lot. Let's see if we're going to spot anyone. Is he still there? He should be just past this waterfall if he hasn't moved yet. I really want to kind of just about miss the waterfall, just like that. Perfect. Is he still there? He is. There's our big boy. There we are, look at that! Bam! Very cool, right? Ooh, cinematic. Ooh, fancy. What the jeebus is... oh, it's broken. The game is doing this a lot today for some reason. It's just stuttering really hard. It's very odd. There we go, back over into safety. Very cool! I really like this. It's pretty much done. The only thing I would need to do is add some poles, like supporting this, probably put some wood across there and just make this whole area just like a little bit more. Well, I want to put some trees there, and then this is the end of the chasm as well. No more chasms. The idea was this is the final. So that wall's going to jut up along there, I think, and then this will be nice and flat, and this can be an exhibit later on. Really awesome. And then yeah, that's it. That is the entire blooming park right there. Done. Took up way less space than I expected. We've got room for 9-10 more animals, perhaps. It's never going to be profitable. We're never, ever going to make money. But, you know, it's cool. I really, really enjoyed it. I do have 2 crocodiles. Where's my other salty? Where are you, buddy? Inda. We're looking for Inda. Inda's on the move. There she is. She's actually not on the move. I did not see her. We swam right past Inda, and we didn't spot her at all. yeah, it's a big area, but I really, I don't know, I just, I think it's pretty cool, I've got to be honest. I do want to jut up the mountain on here. I do want to put some trees in and stuff like that to completely sell it, but I figure I can leave some stuff ready for the tour video, which will, like I say, be the next video along. So you'll be able to see the finalized version in that next episode. We're going to do trees along here, stuff like that. And then this is it's all done. I'm going to put like a big coming soon thing across there, just like we did by the elephants. Usually this is when we would add the crocodiles and make them happy, but as you can see, they are already pretty happy, I think. Yes, 96%, not bad at all. Are they getting fed? That would be nice. It's odd that I can't see a thing in the daytime. I can see it at night, I can't see in day. So, oh, there we go. Did I give them food at all? I gave them a restraint feeder. And a blood pumpkin somewhere. Yes, that's the blood pumpkin there, right? Yeah. So that, they should get refed. We don't need standard feeders. They should be okay just living off that stuff, I think. Although these don't have much. 10 kilograms. 10 kilograms. We'll see. We'll see what happens. But, that's about it, folks. I might do a little bit of decoration. I kind of want to maybe block the buildings off a little bit more. Just some general stuff. Definitely want to make that less floaty. I wonder, I'm not sure I want to attach it logs underneath. I'm thinking like a support structure that kind of attaches it to the wall on the side. That probably makes a little bit more sense. Either way, we'll think of something, cover that in a bit of wood, put some trees up, put some rocks up, and we are done. So next episode will be the final tour of Mai Pen Rai. I do apologise that this little bit at the end is quite short compared to usual. Usually I record for like an hour now and then have to cut it down massively. It's just because we already brought the crocodiles in, because I was very unsure about this, whether this was going to work at all, you know, whether I could keep the crocodiles in via the rocks. I'm sure I talked about that in the time lapse anyway, which I haven't even recorded yet, so it's like I'm sure I've talked about that despite not having talked about it yet, which is crazy. But yeah, really happy how this has turned out. I think that looks really good like that. I think that's beautiful. Waterfall looks great. Waterfall looks great. I'm really glad that I did this little extended little lake coming out. I want to block off that back bit a bit. It's a beautiful new morning in Mai Pen Rai, the national park that will never ever make. It's full of people, absolutely chock-a-block with people, but it's never gonna make a penny. It's amazing. At least the Komodo dragons are getting a little love as well. Oh, I also need donation. I'll tell you what, that's something we can do. I need donation boxes down here by the crocs. I love that this is all, there's a lot of water, but it's tropical. There's lots of water and trees, and then the chasms, and it's not like it has to be a defining feature, but it's just what the world looks like, and it does look to me like a real place that we've kind of melded around, rather than just a big flat plane, you know. It's got personality. The island itself is alive, and that's really what I wanted. I want to cut that down a bit. That's a bit straight for my liking. Let's chuck in some dough boxes, and we are Dunzel, Washington. I guess we're just sick over there. There's not really much else to do with that one. Right then, folks. Yes, we'll be back next episode with the full tour. Very exciting. Prepare for my tour guide voice. I'll make sure all the animals are in. I'm going to have a little bit of a surprise as well in that next video, so definitely come back and check that out. It's going to be pretty cool. Full tour of Mai Pen Rai, and then after that, we'll be starting our next zoo. Again, I think it'll be North America, and then probably one of the three African ones. Probably the savannah, grassland, or the jungle. No, it'll be probably be Africa after that, but we shall see. Right. Okay, well, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for all the support during this whole series, for all your ideas and love and such. And get ready for the tour. Cheers much, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.